Hi, how are you?
Nilsson, see, how are you?
Fine.
Harry.
Otto Preminger.
Nilsson.
Oh, you know each other.
Preminger. We're working together. I see,
6 months every day. My father.
Yes?
Father figure.
Let me show you a little feat of magic that was taught to me by a Hindu magician by the name of Abu Ben Schwartz.
I know him.
I want you to remove a small card. Preferably the two of clubs. Very good. But I want you to autograph the card. You place it right there, please, the two of clubs. And I want you to put a mark on it. Your initial, perhaps. The card now autographed, we have precluded the possibility of my employing a duplicate card. Naturally, when you see it again, you will immediately recognize it to be the card that you that I selected. Watch it go. There it is. Magic words, hachi pachi. There it goes, watch it.
How do you do it?
Extremely well.
I thought you did.
There it goes.
Oh wow.
He's also a counterfeiter. You got to watch him.
At every minute, I would say. Nilsson, I think you're the first pop singer to ever graduate from a bank.
Yes, there were several mother singers who did that a long time ago.
You worked
he
at a bank?
He didn't graduate from the bank. He was thrown out.
He bought me. But you did work in a bank for a number of...
5 years.
5 years before you.
It wasn't actually a bank. It was a computer center for a bank. We did card tricks all night.
Well, listen, as a guy who's always been kind of office-oriented and have my own desk here, I think one tune that you do that I get a special kick out of is about the desk. I wonder whether you might do that since we're here in the study.
I would love to. I will even study it for you. Which might be a bad idea. Do you have any music? I hear it now.
My old desk does an arabesque in the morning when I first arrive. It's a pleasure to see. It's waiting there for me to keep my hopes alive. Such a comfort to know it's got no place to go. It's always there. It's the one thing I've got, a huge success. Good old
man. That's what happens, Jake.
Now my old desk never needs a rest, and I've never once heard it cry. I've never seen it tease. It's always there to please me from 9 to 5. Such a comfort to know it's dependable and slow, but it's always there. Well, it's the one friend I've got, a giant of our times, my good old dad. Isn't picturesque, but it's happy as a desk can be. Now we never say a word, but it's perfectly all right with me. For when my heart's on the floor, I just open the drawer of my favorite guest. And what do I see but a picture of me working at my good old desk?
Thank you.
You deserve a glass of champagne, too.
I think you're right, Frank.
Whatever inspired you originally to write a song about a desk?
It's actually it's not really so much about a desk as it is an anagram game. The initials G-O-D, good old desk, have to do with God.
Thank you, Mr. Champagne. Thank you. Thank you.
After drink, I always break glass. I'm sorry. But it has to do with man's modern concept of the meaning of God today.
I think, as a matter of fact, doing the anagrams in the songs is kind of a popular thing now. And the Beatles do them, too, and
yeah.
They've gotten into a lot of controversy over some of them. Another tune that you do that I enjoy very much is Together.
Oh.
And I think it would be something that would be very nice that the kids might enjoy.
You think you guys can play together for a change?
Now you're embarrassing.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean to say that. Would you hold my drink for me, then?
I certainly will.
Thank you. I will see you.
Curtain in one thing for certain, there's nothing to keep them together. How does it happen to contender, one blender of love and emotion that covered the ocean of sadness that kept them together? Thereafter, the dream had exploded. A promise was broken. Now few words are spoken together.
Kind of quiet gathering?
Yeah, I love it. I love your parties always, wherever they are, in Chicago, in New York, any place.
Well, you and I are both kind of work-oriented, I think, though we know how to play, too, I know.
I'm learning.
At this stage in life, you're just beginning
to learn. What stage in life? You have this preoccupation with youth.
No,
I might be younger
otherwise.
Than you. You never can. You know what I always
you
say.
You sometimes make me feel you're younger than I am, Otto.
No, because I don't know how to take it, but I told you once, and you reminded me tonight, you don't count age from birth because you don't know how long you're going to live. A man who dies at 30, is very old at 29. A man who dies at 93, is very young at 60.
That's right.
And that's at time 60.
I agree.
61.
61, all right. Well, you can see the old
time. And a half, right? Computing constantly.
Well, you're kind
you
of
have a gift to really annoy me.
I'm 27 going on 63. I wouldn't complain.
I think you're...
You know that he did the music to my last picture?
It may be your last picture, too, I'll tell you.
I did.
What do you mean by that? Explain yourself.
Well, I mean...
You make these...
Either I will do it because of my music, or the critics will do it because of my music. One of the two.
Do you know that this picture is more important for you than for me?
You're right.
Because the music is such an important part in this picture, so don't joke.
I never joke about it.
You want all these
It may be the best part of the picture. I
all these people to see.
The film itself, as a matter of fact, is a comedy.
It's
and
peculiar.
It's a peculiar film.
Funny.
Peculiar comedy.
It's the first comedy you've done in a long time.
Skidoo, yeah. In a long, long time.
Why a comedy at this time when the world is involved?
Because of that. Because the world. Why is Playboy so successful? Because the world wants escape. To Playboy.
Stop the world, I want to get off.
And I got him to write the music, and they were tough days.
Excuse me, Hugh, telephone.
Oh, excuse me, Otto.
That's very rude. Very rude.
Hello, dear.
Terrible.
I'm very sorry that you can't make it. Yes, a lot of friends are here.
Another
girl? Yes. This is a girl that you know, Otto. I was just talking to an old friend of yours, Otto Preminger. You would like to talk to Otto? I'll tell you what I'll do. I'll put you on the speakerphone. Barbara, can you put this call on speaker? There's a friend who wants to talk to you, Otto.
Mr. Preminger, dear.
Carol Channing!
Will always be Mr. Preminger, dear, because you are a dear. Yes, you are.
You see? Now, this is lost.
This is my chance to talk and tell you what an experience it was to work with you in Skidoo. Wasn't that something? And you were such a lamb to come all the way to Las Vegas to see my show at the Riviera Hotel. But most of all, you know, honey, most people don't know what great care you have for your fellow man, that you are somewhat of a philanthropist. Yes, you are. First, you donate your heart for a transplant. Anyone who's done business with you since then knows how you love actors. I understand you even gave your hair to Joey Bishop. Now I've said it, and I'm glad. And before you start arguing with me, I'm going to hang up.
What is it like for an independent producer like you? I know that both Jackie Gleason and Carol Channing are in the new film. Any conflict when someone who works with a strong directorial style as you?
No conflict. They're wonderful professionals. It was very easy, and we had other people there like Groucho Marx and, as a matter of fact, and Cesar Romero and Frankie Avalon and George Raft and Mickey Rooney. There was no conflict except with one man who played a small part.
It got smaller and smaller.
And wrote the music.
I understand.
His name, believe it or not, is Nilsson.
That's only part of it.
I tell you something. You know that during the picture, he lost his first name, and I met him in Vasari. During the picture.
I understand that the
did
credits...
you sell it?
Who'd buy it? A name like Harry. Nobody wants a name like Harry. Except Truman.
Well, now Nilsson has something to do with the credits.
Well, I'll tell you what happened. You know, when the picture was over, I decided to put the credit at the end instead of the beginning. Mm-hmm. And I was afraid that people won't stay. You know, everybody who works likes to read his name at the end. Mm-hmm. So we devised something, Harry and I. Harry naturally wrote it. Then I wanted to engage a singer, and he said, no, he'll sing it. As a matter of fact, in the film, he sings it, believe it or not, with four voices. He laid one over the other. He didn't permit anybody to come here.
And he sings the credits.
Although, wait a minute, there's another song. And
not only that,
he sings.
He gave himself first four credits, then I had to cut one. He now has 3.5.
Would you sing the credits for Otto's picture for the kids here?
Yeah. I'll show you.
It's really got to be unique.
Sit down here. I want you to know at the end, you know, a little boat is sailing. In the boat is Groucho Marx and a wonderful young actor called Austin Pendleton, and they smoke, but they don't smoke those old-fashioned things that you smoke. They smoke what we in Vienna call pot. And I suddenly say, stop! We are not through yet. And before you skidoo, we want to introduce our cat. We want to.
Take
I changed
two.
It.
It's all right then.
We want...
I guess
this is what I got. The whole picture.
Will you please start again? Now, this time, do it correctly, will you?
Stop.
You're on camera.
Stop. Right. We're not through yet. Mm-hmm. And before you skidoo, I'd like to introduce the cast and crew. Go.
Oh, go.
Jackie Gleason was Tony Banks, Carol Channing Flo, Frankie Avalon, Angie, Fred Clark, a tower guard, Michael Constantine Leach, Frank Gorshin, the man, John Philip Law, Stash, Peter Lawford, the senator, Burgess Meredith, the warden, George Rapp.
Wait a minute.
No, the warden. You must at least get to your
own. This is 4 minutes long, Otto. I can't.
Wait a minute.
That's it.
Right. Copyright MCMLXBIII by Sigma Productions Incorporated. All rights reserved. Your seats on fire.
How's your popcorn?
My popcorn's fine, thank you. I will play.